number 70 of 2019, last week on Wednesday, I take in and admit the proposals that many our colleagues made here in regards to further amendments to the particular bill, and I invite them further to review it and bring forth the amendments when we get to the third reading. This clearly shows that we've all fallen victim of embarrassments with very funny content is brought on TV, especially when you are seated with members of the family in the house. It's usually very embarrassing to see somebody dancing naked while advertising alcohol. You know, when you are seated with your teenage kids, it's usually very embarrassing to see that. You actually feel like you need to switch off your TV. So the bill, as I said earlier, sets to review such content, and not just content, but also the timelines that such content should be brought on TV, if it must be brought. And that is why I invite the honorable members, when you get to the third reading, the further amendments that most of them proposed, you know, in regard to what should be termed as moral content and what should be termed as immoral, what regulation should be set, of course, and with the punitive measures, like Honorable Milly said, that 500,000 for the defaulters, or rather for the for those who will, of course, not comply with the law, is a bit lenient, and she felt that we should set higher retributive measures, you know, for purposes of morality, so that we are able to save the next generation. Several members, of course, said that young families are dying, and they also young families are fighting. People are not able to raise their children well because of this alcoholism. And it's upon us now to set the ground earlier, to set people earlier, to try and twist the content that is brought on TV. We might not really be able to kill immorality and bad manners and drug abuse in the country entirely through one angle, but at least we can try, even if it's 5%, to limit such content that motivates our young ones, to do some immoral things, and to engage themselves in drug abuse. And such one such way is by limiting the timelines that this alcohol is brought on our screens, by also directing, or rather regulating, the content that is brought on TV when one is advertising a certain type of a drink, alcoholic drink. Because as I said, sex is not related to alcohol. How they try to twist it and marry them and bring them forth on TV between 8 and 9 when you're seated with your kids, teenage kids, is very confusing. And that is why we are pushing for this. And for that reason, as I thank the honorable members and I invite them for the third reading, as we seek further to review the regulations, I beg to